Hi there, Santa Fe. In case you haven't noticed, there's been an increase in the chatter about the chart process coming up. For those of you that may not be aware, the chart process is the third rendition of a type of governmental process pushed by Mayor Weber that will be used to judge every public work of art and historical monument, sculpture, and item in the city of Santa Fe, no matter how old or historical it is, starting with the Soldiers Monument that was attacked last fall. Literally anything and everything could be on the chopping block. Remember that one of the core reasons Santa Fe is different than every other place is because of our unique historical value. When you read the papers and listen to Mayor Weber, don't be fooled with words like reconcile and peace. It's all very one-sided. Weber is very well spoken, and that helps make him what he is, a very capable liar. In this video, I'm going to talk briefly about some newer information regarding this process, and then move to some clips from my In Defense of Santa Fe Part 3, where I spend some time exposing this chart process for what it is, a sham. I also discuss this with Dr. Pauline Anaya, who has firsthand experience with this type of process from Albuquerque, and Virgil Vigil, the president of Union Protectiva. As evidence that this process will be a sham, let's look for a minute at the proposed contractor. Now, keep in mind that I've been saying that this will be an unfair process because it will be loaded with mostly people who agree with the mayor about the continued erasure of the Spanish culture and history here in Santa Fe. The proposed contractor, at over $250,000, is an organization called Artful Life. Sounds great on the surface, doesn't it? The founding director is a woman named Valerie Martinez. Valerie Martinez brags openly on her page about being part of the process that ended the Law and Trotha tradition. Aha, gotcha. This was part of the beginning of the assault on the local Hispanic community, and here she is at the center of it, bragging about her part. And now the mayor wants to use her company as part of the farce sham appearance of fairness in the community. The mayor of Santa Fe is taking precious, extremely historical things of the city and treating them as his own personal common playthings. Maybe he likes one or doesn't like another. Let's throw de Vargas out, but leave Native American warrior statues up, etc. Then, to attempt to hide that fact, he starts a process that will have a predetermined outcome so he can have his cake and eat it too, all while looking like he's left all of this up to the public. Weber is attempting to play God with historical things of the city. The problem is, he's not God. He's a reckless child who thinks he knows 100 times more about history than he actually does. Here are some excerpts from my part 3 of In Defense of Santa Fe, where I explore this chart process. Card number 10. The truth committing chart reconciled group persons of super justice and truthing panel. Oh, wait. Now it's the Truth and Reconciliation Committee. No, wait. It's changed again. Now it's the Chart Committee. Yeah, that's it. This is a similar model committee that was successful at etching away at the Hispanic culture in Albuquerque. It will be a type of straw man or Trojan horse, probably made up of mostly woke people or well-intended people who are either ignorant to what is actually going on here or unaware that they're being used. Now I'd like to introduce you to Dr. Pauline Anaya. Dr. Anaya traces her Spanish family history back to the 1500s. Among a long list of credentials, she's been a lifelong educator and psychotherapist, and is currently the president of the Juan Bautista de Anza Society and vice president of the New Mexico Hispanic Cultural Preservation League. She recently served on Albuquerque's version of the Chart Committee and is very familiar with the way these committees are set up and run. Here's part of a conversation I had with her the other day. Please excuse the poor internet connection.
I did want to get your opinion a little bit because you do have quite a bit of experience and knowledge when it comes to what's being proposed in Santa Fe and actually in process of right now in the Chart Committee, which is something I'd like to get your opinion on as well. What can you tell me about that process in general, and as far as, you know, your experience with similar things?
There is a process called the Delphi technique out of that that's used by individuals who want a predetermined outcome to things. So to appear as though there's an open community input and meeting, this technique is used. And this is exactly when the takedown of the Oñate statue in Albuquerque. I was there at the whole setup, and it was very interesting how the city had set that up. And they had set up the stage, they put up microphones, they put up chairs, and they had already invited a group of individuals who were against the Ornada, were against the history of the Spanish people in New Mexico. And so without even police present there, I was like, well, this is interesting. All kinds of people, different people from out of town were showing up, and Antifa's in black and all this. I was going, this is really interesting that here we are in New Mexico and we have the same, you know, kind of scenario that is going on in the Northwest, and it's brought here, and the people come in, fly in, you know, are paid to participate. And, so just to see it all play out was very disheartening. And then, of course, the ultimate was that, since, you know, the police were told to stand down or not be show a presence much, of course, the statue was going to come down. And I know Sonny Rivera, who's one of the sculptors, and Betty Sabo, who's passed, but he received a phone call from the mayor's office, I believe it is, or from cultural affairs, and saying, we are wanting to take down this, or we would like your permission, or we would, you know, we want to save it and not, so it doesn't get damaged. So we'd like to take it down, if you would support us taking it down. And of course he says, well, of course I want it to be, I don't want it to be destroyed. So everything was very controlled again, because they already had a predefined outcome they were looking for.
Right. So you are actually part of this process in Albuquerque, and you're saying from the inside that that this process was loaded to begin with. It was prearranged to have a predeterminant built inside of it, and it was restricted to the point where you really couldn't actually express yourself.
So okay. It was pretty much pre-set up, predetermined, obviously, because the question was, are we going to take this statue down or not?
Wow, that's incredible insight. Thank you for that. And so it's your belief that Santa Fe is in process of basically enacting this same type of model along with that Delphi technique to the Santa Fe community?
Correct. And I believe people should Google Delphi, D-E-L-P-H-I technique, so that they can have a 5-minute video on a demonstration, how it's used in meetings and how it's used, so that you'll know what you're going to be faced, because it's facilitators, the expert facilitators, who select who's in those meetings. So pretty much if you have 3 people who are of the dissenting side and 6 people who are of the other supporting side, then of course you're going to have a skewed view.
Okay. All right. Wow. Thank you so much for your insight on that. And thank you so much for, you know, taking the time to talk to me. I really appreciate it.
In the past, in various kingdoms, when a king would take over or wipe out a movement, he sometimes would keep a weaker-minded member of his opposition alive, treat them well, and even include them on councils to the king. Now, that person didn't know this, but the king was just using them to give the appearance of fairness and open-mindedness and diversity of thought on his council. So when critics would say that the king had wiped out a movement or had treated a people group or opposing party unfairly, the king could hide behind the sham diversity and say things like, "If I'm so unfair, then explain how I have this man on my council who disagrees with me." There are a few names for these people. One of those names is the court fool, not to be confused with a court jester or clown. This person would often live a very good life, thinking they were standing up for a good cause and feel good about themselves, and mostly be completely unaware that in reality, They were part of an enabling mechanism fashioned by the king. And although these people were usually well-meaning, they usually did more harm than good in the long run. This is partially how I see what is currently called the Chart Committee. If you are currently on the Chart Committee, I caution you to be aware of the possibility that you might be being used as a pawn to come up with the conclusions or decisions that the mayor and some of the city council want you to, instead of making more difficult calls that go against current city officials. This is exactly the position that the mayor put the Fiesta Council and the Caballeros de Vargas in a couple years ago. It's pretty much the same thing. Also consider the demographic makeup of the committee. Are these people who have had a historical stake in the decisions being made? Do they have generations of history here as they're being asked to consider things generations old? Does the percentage of the committee members represent the population percentages for those community members of whom's history representations are on the chopping block? The answer is mostly no. This chart committee has no right to make decisions about historical items and celebrations that mean nothing to most of them, yet are precious to others who are not represented adequately enough percentage-wise. This committee, as the one before it, is not an adequate social device to deliver lasting resolve. The probability is they will take forever to make a bad decision that will be reversed soon in years to come.
Well, the chart is a Marxist program, okay, that is designed to give them the results that they want. And he will, I guarantee you, and I asked him not to, but he's going to be appointing those individuals that dislike our culture. The mayor wants to change us.
Yeah.
He wants to change us. And that's unfortunately, one guy is able to do that. That's horrible.
Wow.
We've had Anglo mayors, Mayor Koss, Mayor Pick, okay? Mm-hmm. They accepted us. We have a Mayor Weber that's moved into here that has not assimilated to Santa Fe, okay? He hasn't been able to accept who we are and where we came from.
The city's current leadership, unfortunately, is contributing to more radical division, not less. It is an unfortunate commonality that even well-meaning government intervention into various issues will harm one group while helping another. Most of the time, when government gets involved trying to help, they shoot one demographic in the leg while trying to help another. This is the case here, and the Spanish community are the ones at the losing end of the gun, unfortunately.